So, what are my thoughts on Blink-182's first album, Cheshire Cat? Cyberland, coming back to you with another album review, and this time, I've been waiting a minute to get these things ready, and it's just, I don't know, maybe it's because I've been doing the covers for this band, like, learning the guitar parts, it's gotten me more fixated to want to do the reviews for these albums, but anyway. Cheshire Cat. So, let me begin with this one. This was not the first album I heard by Blink. Actually, I never knew. I didn't know. You know how I found out about this album? I found out about this album because I remember when Enema came out, people were fucking tripping about Blink at the time, and they were like, oh, Blink sold out so long ago, blah, blah, blah. You know, the typical shit, and it's just like, whatever, man. And people would say, yeah, well, Blink's best album was Cheshire Cat. That was their best album, and they sold out. And I'm like, you know, it's funny, because I always hear people talk about Dude Ranch being their best album, and they sold out. So what the fuck ever. And I think I found out about Cheshire Cat at some point when I was in college. I know it wasn't after the hiatus, but it was some point in college. And I just acquired it, and I listened to it, and really, actually, what it was I kept hearing Eminem's on the radio every so often, and it sounded like Mark, and then I did some research, like, and it was Blink, and Eminem was on Cheshire Cat. So I listened to it, and it was kind of a throwaway thing for me at the time. I wouldn't say turned off, but I wasn't really listening to it that much, was because the quality, the sound quality, you know, and you, back then, you know, you're not a major label, you know, you're not a major label money, so the sound is maybe not be the best, and I just didn't really put much thought into it. I listened to it, but I was just like, it felt like a throwaway, and when I feel like I'll listen to it, but now, you know, I'm older, things have changed, and I listen to it, I don't listen as much as all the other stuff, but I still listen to it, and still gets a good amount of spins. It's a pretty good album, Yeah, I just went through it, and it's kind of funny, like, some of the names for the songs, I think that's what makes it really funny, but the one thing I liked about it was how Mark and Tom were playing, and, you know, Scott, of course, that's the drummer when they first started with their album, and Travis was later, but it was cool, you know. It wasn't anything to me to write home about per se, but it was just fun. It was like, it wasn't serious like Green Day was. It was more comical, but not too comical, but just fun. It was just a fun album. And, you know, it did show what the band was able to achieve, that they were gonna eventually elevate if they keep making music like this. And I think that's pretty much that's pretty much what happened. You know, in retrospect about where the band started, where they went.
You know,
some bands will kind of go like this, and then they don't go that far. They just fall apart. They never make it to get to that peak to where everybody knows who they are. Blink wasn't one of those bands. So, my rating for this album, I give it a 4 out of 5. I think it's a nice introduction. But it's not, like I said, it's not my favorite album. I mean, I don't rank it. I don't know if I even put it at the bottom. I think it's just because all the stuff that came later is better than it, I guess you could say.
That's a fun album.
So, my top five tracks is Carousel, Eminem's, Touchdown Boy. I love Touchdown Boy because it kind of gives me, like, regardless of the lyrics, it kind of gives me, like, the way Tom's playing the guitar, what was going to become of later stuff, like, you know, you get with later songs and stuff. Wasting Time, and then Peggy Sue. Those are my top five tracks. I think, and the funny thing is, you know, Carousel, that's the other thing. Before I got into Treasure Cat, I'd always hear Mark play this bass part, and people would go nuts, and I was like, what? I didn't know what the song was, and then I hear him play it live, and I was like, well, this is a pretty good song. And then when I finally heard what the original sounds like, and I was like, wait a minute, that's not how it starts? Why does it... And then, like, it's like, oh, okay, so they cut the very beginning to give that more effect where it just has Mark intro. And then Tom comes in with guitars and stuff. So it's kind of cool. I would say if you're, you know, if you like Blink's stuff, then it's not a bad album. I'd say pick it up. If you like all the other stuff that come up with it, check it out. If you just want more of, you know, the popular albums that everybody tends to know, really, then, you know, other per se, I guess, but if you like the other stuff, you'll enjoy it more. It's very complicated, and it's just fun. It's not to be taken too seriously. Maybe a couple songs here and there, but it's not serious as Layer Down the Road. With that being said, you know, we just cue the music. Food every once in a while, but not enough to purchase a file. I think of gas as a treasure to me. I know now that nothing is free. I talk to you every now and then.